What does it mean when someone says that you have rhythm? Well, according to this Maximilian Encyclopedia of Music and Musicians, the definition of rhythm is the time relation among tones which is expressed by strong or accented and weak or unaccented beats. These beats may be arranged in various times, duple consisting of a strong blah, 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 blah. Yeah. Well, rhythm certainly has quite an academic definition. In fact, that definition went on for about half the page in this grand old book. But what we want to really discover is how that element of rhythm is used in the music that we listen to. How can we distinguish what rhythm is? And how do different songs and styles and different composers use rhythm to get different emotions across or to have you get up and want to dance? So that's the first element of music that we're going to be discovering in creative music. So let's get started and talk about rhythm in terms of different styles of music and how we perceive and hear that music. If I were to ask you if this particular song, which is Chuck Berry, has rhythm, of course you would say it does. But what do you mean? What rhythm? What do you define as rhythm? Do you define me nodding my head here as the rhythm? Or do you define the piano in the background playing those triplets as the rhythm? Or is the melody that he's singing the rhythm? See, all of those things are rhythm, but they're used differently. The first thing we're going to look at in the class is what a quarter note is and how we can hear quarter notes. And right now, this song has a very, very strong quarter note. If you were sitting here listening to the song with us, you'd be bopping your head or moving, and that's the quarter note. But a quarter note's not the only type of rhythm. There's eighth notes, 16th notes, 32nd notes, there's polyrhythms. There's a copious amount of notation of rhythms. But don't get too overwhelmed by it all. Lots of great music and musicians don't know how to read music and perform music without knowing how to read music. It's a skill that'll help you and help you to build your vocabulary, but it won't necessarily make you a better musician or performer, although I hope it might. So although the quarter note is very apparent in this song, let's listen to another song where you might not hear it as much. So now we're listening to Bach. And this is a little tricky, okay? Because when I'm sitting here listening to it, I could be misled to think that maybe the quarter note is right there. But really it's not. And really the only reason why I know that is because I know that the time signature is 4/4, and I know what the tempo is, which are two other important elements that can help define what the rhythm is for a particular song. Really, the quarter note is here. And the pianist, Peter Serkin, is playing 16th notes. The strong pulse that we hear in this particular piece is actually eighth notes. So once you become a little bit more knowledgeable about time signatures and what tempo is, you'll be better able to navigate and hear what those different pulses are in the music. Okay, so let's get started then. We're going to talk about time signature, tempo, and also talk about what a quarter note is today. Quarter note and a quarter note rest. Now, all this stuff is in your binder. All the definitions and all the quarter notes and subdivisions are in your binder. So if you need to have notes to look at, you can always look at your binder. Everything's in the binder that you've gotten for the class.
And what is the time signature? Well, the time signature is the roadmap to your piece of music. It's one of the first things you look at if you're a musician reading some music.
And what it tells you is how many beats are in a measure and what kind of note is going to get one beat. But hand in hand with the time signature is going to be what the tempo is. Because the tempo is going to tell you how fast or how slow your piece of music is going to go. Most of the music that we listen to or that you listen to on the radio is in 4/4. What does that mean is that there's 4 beats per measure and that a quarter note gets one beat. Now you're like, what's a measure? Well, a measure is in between these two lines, and these two lines are called bar lines. So this is one measure of music here. If I put another bar line there, guess what? That's 2 measures of music. So a quarter note is represented by the number 4. In 4/4 time, a quarter note gets one beat. So if I'm listening to some music at a certain tempo, let's just say I count out a piece of music and I say, okay, everybody, we're gonna all clap quarter notes, and I count out 1, 2, that's the tempo. So everyone's gonna clap 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And if someone had to notate that, or if we were reading music, it would look exactly like this. 4 quarter notes in one measure. Now, if I were to count it out faster, it would sound the same thing, but faster. I say, okay, we're going to play 4 quarter notes. Here's the tempo. 1, 2, 3, 4. We'd all clap. Now, here's a trick question for you. What am I clapping right now? I can't even clap that fast. Well, I didn't tell you the tempo, nor did I tell you the time signature, so you really don't know. I could be clapping 16th notes, I could be clapping whole notes, I could be clapping 32nd notes. It's all tied into this. Again, I want to reinforce that this is all Western music theory, and many cultures do not use time signatures like this or even use notation that's like this. And it doesn't validate and make this type of music more important than other types of music, because music is oral. And being able to hear it and perform it is even more important than always having to read it on the page. But again, it just helps everyone to communicate and be able to play music. People can be together in the same room and not speak the same language, but music, Western notation is a universal language, and these musicians can come, sit down together, and if everyone has music, can play and communicate to one another. So that's the one advantage of the Western notation system. So what we're going to do now is we're going to put on some music and we're going to clap different rhythms with quarter